Good afternoon, I say good evening. Here's Ford Mustang 98 guy, and today let's take an in-depth look at the 2013 Audi Q5 2.0. It's a 2.0 turbo. It's a Quattro. Hell. Nothing. Today I'm going to give you all a full in-depth walk around of the Q5. I'm going to start it, and I'm also going to show the engine. I'm also going to show you all the interior and the exterior of the SUV. Yes, Lucas. Just try not to say stupid things. It's going on YouTube. It's got 55,000 kilometers on it, and they're asking about 36,500. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and start it up.
Come on.
Let it run.
Get started.
I'm gonna start it. Don't worry. White exterior. Oh, also you have smart key access system as well. Just keep the key fob in your pocket. As you can see, you put your hand behind the door handle, automatically unlocks the car. And to lock it, tap that sensitive pad right there, and then it's very easy to do.
Where?
White exterior.
Okay, so how long are you gonna be? I don't know.
With a dark brown leather interior. It's a little bit windy. Low kilometers on it too. To start it, all you gotta do, put your foot on the brake and take the key fob, insert into the slot here and hold. Or you just push that key fob slot in. Close the door. Yeah. Get a 4-spoke leather wrapped steering wheel. Very easy to turn. I believe this is a 5-speed automatic transmission. You also have manual shift mode right there. You can also put it into S mode if you want. You also have a reverse camera with guidance lines right there. And then, no. When you put it in reverse, the mirrors fold down as well. But I don't think they do. I saw them fold. Pretty nifty. With the shift boot right there. The emergency brake. It actually has an electronic parking brake. That's the emergency brake. Oh, you can also start it two ways. This is what you can do. I noticed. You take the key fob here, and voila, push button starts. So keep the key inside and push this button right here. Wow. You can do it two ways. Anyways, we're gonna go ahead and flip on the automatic headlights, run over your fog lights, and we'll turn on the hazards. And we'll check out the outside. I do have another Q5 on my channel as well, so please sure check that one out. Standard Continental tires. Let's see if I get it's windy out today. Exhaust. Oh, pop. SUV, not truck. It's a small SUV. Oh, it's windy. Let's pop the hood.
engine. Hood latch.
2.0 liter turbo, four cylinder. Oh yeah, it's windy outside. Windows, power mirrors. You also have heated exterior mirrors, power door locks there, window lock, two-person memory, storage down there, full power seats.
You also have I don't think you have a tilt steering wheel, but actually the lever's down here.
Manually tilting steering wheel. Alright, so no revving on this one. I've been told not to rev the cars. So, shutting the doors, pretty quiet. Automatic climate control right here. Also shows up there. Same on this side. Oh man, this thing has to warm up. Turn the fan. The fuck? Your fan speed, front and rear defrost, different modes. Right there. Aluminum three-stage heated seats for the driver and passenger. If you have one-touch automatic, air conditioning as well. You got it all there. Ashtray, cigarette lighter in there as well. You have your cup holders right there. Storage, center armrest. Show you the radio screen. You also have navigation as well. All controlled by this wheel. Radio. Bluetooth telephone. Media. Back to the radio screen. Do a little sound test. Not bad. Stereo sounds great. Automatic dimming rearview mirror. Map lights. You have your map lights up there. Power sunroof. Oh, you can probably cool. And that comes all the way back. Come on. Takes too long to do. It's just like that other one I did. Look at that. You can also open it too. Sunglass storage in there. Can I have your instrument cluster? You have your engine temperature, tachometer, speedometer, and your gas gauge is right there. Trip computer, you also have driver information system too. Radio station as well. Your turn signals off to this side. Wipers. Steering wheel is so easy to turn, you can tell. Look at that. Look at her wrist. Alright. Here's the key fob. So you can start it two ways, so. Not bad. Alright, let's go ahead and put the window back down halfway. And I think that's pretty much about it. We'll check out the back. Here's the back seat. Ocean handles, interior light. I don't know what that is. Air vents. You also have heated seats back here too. Cup holders too. Okay. Open the hatch. What the fuck? Who did this? Open the fucking hatch. There.
Oh, it's dripping water. But it's nice and clean. You can also close it like that as well. Pretty nifty. The flag came off. I gotta fix the flag. The flag kind of broke. And I won't be able to get the side, so this is all due. I gotta fix the flag. Oh God almighty, the flag broke. Ha! It's too windy, that's why. It doesn't even want to hold. Here's the other side. Shut this off. Power outlet in there. Forgot to view that. Step on inside. We also have power seats for the passenger side too. Oh, it's windy. Watch.
Glove box.
I don't like small cars, man. I like big. I like the Q7 I reviewed back a while ago. Oh, the stupid flag. I gotta fix it now. Fuck, it flew off. Stupid thing. How the hell that happened? Put it inside for a second. Okay, let's shut this one off. Shut it down. Please remove key. Key's out. And I'll fix that window in a second. Well guys, hope you guys enjoyed the full in-depth walk around of the 2013 Audi Q5. Stay tuned for my next video. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching and goodbye. This one also here is for sale at Maple Acura. So if you're interested, please let them know you saw this video. Take care, everyone.